السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, are you ready? Are you prepared? Ramadan is around the corner. And I'm sure that my brothers and sisters, this Ramadan is going to be different from any other Ramadan we spend in our lives. Because subhanAllah, this generation, our generation, is passing through this tough time. And we didn't experience anything like that before. This Ramadan is going to be without a prayer in Salat al-Taraweeh in the Masjid. This Ramadan is going to be without making i'tikaf in the Masjid. This Ramadan is going to be without, you know, my brothers, listening to the lectures in the masjid, visiting one another, shaking hands with one another, hugging one another. But inshallah ta'ala, we hope that our masajid will be open soon. As the poet said, مَا بَيْنَ طَرْفَةِ عَيْنٍ وَانْتِبَاهَتِهَا يُغَيِّرُ اللَّهُ مِنْ حَالٍ إِلَى حَالٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes situations from one case to another, from one state to another in a blink of an eye. So think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Antib nafsan. My brothers and sisters in Islam, on such days last year, we were preparing ourselves for the arrival of the month of Ramadan. And we're talking about how to prepare yourself for it in order to attain Allah's mercy during the blessed month, in order to gain Allah's forgiveness, in order to have your body being freed from the hellfire, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us. Subhanallah, from Ramadan to Ramadan, it's as though it was yesterday. Time flies, time passes quickly, and this is actually the first lesson we learn from the arrival of the month of Ramadan. Time passes quickly and your life too. Ask your father, ask your grandfather who is like 80, 90 years old. How did his life pass? How did his life pass? He will tell you that, subhanallah, my son, it's as though it was yesterday. It's as though it was yesterday. And that's the nature of this life. That's the nature of the life of the world. And that's the nature of time. Time waits for no one. Time waits for no one. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. And it is actually, my brothers, one of the minor signs of Judgment Day, that time will pass so quickly. It is one of the minor signs of Judgment Day. As it is narrated in the authentic hadith, that is narrated on the authority of Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَن تَقُومَ السَّاعَ حَتَّى يُقْبَضَ الْعِلْمِ. The hour will not begin until knowledge is taken away. وَتَكْثُرَ الزَّلَازِلِ. Earthquakes increase. وَيَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ. And time passes quickly. Tribulations appear. And there is a lot of harj, which is killing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all and protect us all from the fitan. مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنْ. What is hidden from it and what is apparent as well. So my brothers, according to this hadith, it is one of the minor signs of Judgment Day that time passes quickly. So we have to prepare ourselves not only for the month of Ramadan, but for meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Judgment Day is about to, I'm telling you that Ramadan is around the corner, and I'm about to say Judgment Day is around the corner. Judgment Day, the hour is about to strike. And we are not prepared. We are not prepared. We are not getting ourselves ready for meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the hadith that is narrated by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, on the authority of Abi Huraira, authentic hadith, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَن تَقُومَ السَّاعَ حَتَّى يَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ. The hour will not begin until time passes quickly. So A year will be like a month, and a month will be like a week, and a week will be like a day, and a day will be like an hour, and an hour will be like the burning of a braid of palm leaves. Passes quickly. Time passes quickly, my brothers. So we have to pause and reflect upon, how do I spend my time? How do I spend my time? Do I waste my time, or do I make the most of it? Subhanallah, my brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by time in the Quran in more than one verse. In more than one verse. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by something, it is indicative of its importance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to bring our attention to the importance of these things. For example, this thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by the time. He said in the Quran, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَا وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by time in the Quran, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to bring our attention to the importance of time. It's a direct message to every single one of us not to waste his time. Don't waste your time. Time is priceless. Time is priceless. Time is your life. And I have a question for you, my brothers. Before asking this question, we know that, my brothers, that we are not allowed to leave our houses. We are not allowed to leave our houses, otherwise our lives will be in danger. And we are not allowed to go and visit our friends and have fun with them. Why? Because we have to abide by the regulations imposed by the government authorities due to the global coronavirus crisis. Okay, طيب. The question is, alhamdulillah, you have plenty of time? You have plenty of time. How do you spend it? How do you spend your time? Wallahi, Shaykh, you know, I'm so depressed. I'm so depressed. Okay, I know that you are depressed. And inshallah ta'ala, we are going to make a video about depression, how to overcome it and how to deal with it, and the cure for it, inshallah ta'ala, soon. But the question is very clear. How do you spend your time? Wallahi, Shaykh, I stay up late at night. Oh, mashallah, praying Qiyam al-Layl, reading the Quran, reciting or making tasbih and adhkar, making something beneficial. Actually, Shaykh, wallah, I told you, Shaykh, from the beginning, I'm so depressed. Huh? I stay up late at night, playing video games with my friends, chatting with my friends. Wallah, Shaykh, yani, trying to waste my time, trying to kill my time. Listen to me, my brothers, and listen to me, my sisters. Your time is your life. Your time is your life. And the one who wastes it actually is slowly committing suicide. Follow stop. That's it. If you are among those who are wasting the time, be sure that you are killing yourself. You are committing suicide. You are committing suicide. I have a question for you. Can any one of you, my brothers and sisters, give me a precise definition of himself? Can you give me a precise definition of yourself? Who are you? Are you telling me I'm a human being? Of course, I know that you are a human being. I know that you are not an alien or something else. I know you are a human being. But again, can you give me a precise definition of the human being, of yourself? Who are you? I will tell you, my brothers. You are nothing but a number of days and nights. You are nothing but a number of days and nights. Al-Imam al-Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullahu ta'ala, said, Ya ibn Adam, innama anta ayyamun ma'duda. Fa'idha dhahaba yawmuk, dhahaba ba'duk. Wa yushiku an yadhhaba al-kullu bil-ba'd. Allah. Al-Imam al-Hasan al-Basri said, O son of Adam, you are nothing but a number of days and nights. Whenever each day passes, then part of you has already gone, and soon all of you will go. You depart the life of the world and pass away. مَا مِن يَوْمٍ يَنْشَقُّ فَجْرُهُ إلا وينادي مناد إلا وينادي يا ابن آدم أنا خلق جديد. Not a day comes from the days of the life of the world but says, O son of Adam, أنا خلق جديد. I'm a new day. وعلى عملك شهيد. And I'm a witness for deeds performed during my stay. فاغتنمني. Make benefit from me. فإني لا أعود إلى يوم القيامة. Make benefit from me. For if the sun sets, I will never return until the day of resurrection. I will never return until the day of resurrection. So see my brothers, time is priceless. And you are killing your time. And you are actually killing yourself and committing suicide. Isn't it time for you to reflect upon the ayat and the hadith and stop wasting your time and make the most of it? Isn't it the proper time for all of us to stop wasting our time? Reflect upon the arrival of the month of Ramadan and make the most of it? So brothers and sisters in Islam, that's the reality of the life of the world. That's the dunya that we are fighting with one another for its sake. That's the dunya that we are turning away from one another for its sake. That's the dunya that we are killing one another for its sake. That's the dunya we are backbiting our other, swearing at one another for its sake. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. You know, my brothers, what does dunya mean? Have you ever asked yourself about the meaning or the literal meaning of the life of the world of dunya? What does dunya mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about the Prophet ﷺ when he was in the journey of Isra Mi'raj, ثُمَّ دَنَا فَتَدَلَّ ثُمَّ دَنَا دَنَا يَدْنُ. So dunya, its derivation is from the root دَنَا يَدْنُ, which means someone or something draws nearer to something else, gets closer to something else. And the life of the world is given that name because it's very short. It will very short and it will come to the end very, very soon. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. So my brothers, in the Quran, I have some verses for you. Let's recite some verses of the Quran, bring some verses of the Quran and reflect upon. Let's ponder over some verses of the Quran. You know the people of the cave, Ashabul Kahf? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused them to sleep in the cave for how long? For 109 years. When they woke up, what did they say? They said, قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. 109 years. 109 years is equal in the sight to a day or half of a day or part of a day. You know, Uzair the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused him to die for 100 years. Allah said in the Quran, أَوْ كَالَّذِي مَرَّ عَلَىٰ قَرْيَةٍ وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَىٰ عُرُوشِهَا. Uzair passed by this, but a town which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely destroyed. Then he said, أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. He said to himself, how could Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give life to this town, to this city, after it has been destroyed? فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ مِئَةَ عَامٍ ثُمَّ بَعْثَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused him to die for 100 years. ثُمَّ بَعْثَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought him back to life and asked him, كَمْ لَبِثْتْ. How long did you stay a dead? How long? He said, same answer. He answered the same answer, my brothers. He said, قَالَ لَبِثْتُ يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. He said, I remained a day or part of a day. On Judgment Day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us, قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سِنِينَ. Allah said, how long did you remain on earth? We will say, قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. Same answer. We will say, we remain the day or part of a day. But ask those who used to count. قَالَ إِن لَبِثْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا We stayed not but for a little while, but فَاسْأَلِ الْعَدِ But إِن لَبِثْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ You stayed, you didn't stay but for a little while, but ask those who used to count. That's my brothers, the reality of the life of the world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَأَنَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَهَا كَأَنَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَهَا لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا When they see judgment day and the horrible things and horrible events that will happen therein, it will be as though they didn't stay except for عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا Part of the night or part of the day. That's exactly the parable of the life of the world. So subhanallah, my brothers, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam slept upon a mat. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam slept upon a mat, and the mat had left some marks on the Prophet's sides. And he was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of Allah's creations. He was Sayyidu Waladi Adam, the master of the human being. He was Khalilullah, he was the close friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he slept upon a mat, and the mat had left some marks on his side. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu entered upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, Hatha Kisra, wa Hatha Qaisar, look at the kings and the sultans and subhanallah, and you are Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Afala nattakhidhu laka firashan wa thiram? Ya Rasulullah, we could get a comfortable bed for you. You are Rasulullah. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? He said, Mali walid-dunya, wa mali dunya wa mali. Ya Umar, mali walid-dunya, wa mali dunya wa mali. What do I have to do with the life of the world? I'm not in the life of the world, but as a writer seeking shade under tree for a little while, then he left. ما أنا في الدنيا إلا كراكب استظل تحت شجرة ثم راح وتركها. That's exactly the parable of the life of the world. For how long you're gonna stay under the shade of the tree? 10 minutes, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, more or less, and then what? You are going to depart. You are going to leave. Make the most of your time. Make the most of your time, my brothers and sisters in Islam. You'll be asked before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about every single minute. No, every single second you spend in this life. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرَّ يَرَى That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam urged every Muslim to make the most of his time and to hasten to perform good deeds. As he said in the authentic hadith, hasten to perform good deeds before trials and tribulations strike. A man will be a believer in the morning and he turns to be a disbeliever in the evening. And he is a believer in the evening and he turns to be a believer in the morning. He sells his religion for any of the worldly gains. بَادِرُوا بِالْأَعْمَالِ سَبْعًا Hasten to perform good deeds before you are overtaken by one of the seven afflictions. What are you waiting for? Rasulullah is asking you. It's a rhetorical question. What are you waiting for? مَا أَلْ تَنْتَظِرُونَ إِلَّا فَقْرًا مُنْسِيَا أَوْ غِنًا مُطْغِيَا أَوْ مَرَضًا أَوْ هَرَمًا مُفَنِّدًا أَوْ مَوْتًا مجهزة أو الدجال أو الساعة والساعة أدهى وأمر What are you waiting for? Are you waiting for poverty to make you unmindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or are you waiting for prosperity which will make you corrupt? Or are you waiting for disease which will make you disabled? Or are you waiting for senility which make you mentally unwell? Or are you waiting for a dajjal? Or are you waiting for the hour? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is urging you not to waste your time and not to wait. Don't say, inshallah, I will repent when the Ramadan comes. Who told you? Who is your guarantor that you are going to live until the next Ramadan comes? You may pass away now. You may pass away. Don't delay repentance. Now, my brothers, this is the first lesson we deduce and we learn from the arrival of the month of Ramadan. Time passes quickly and you'll be asked before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about it. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man's feet will never move on judgment day before he's asked about his life. How did he consume it? His knowledge. How did he get it? And what did he do with his knowledge? And you asked before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the money as well. How did you acquire it and how did you spend it? So my brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to be determined in making the most of our time and getting ourselves prepared for the month of Ramadan. Barakallahu azza wa jalla li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in. I will see you inshallah on Monday at the same time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.